Once again, a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back to online class. Let us continue with the chapter trigonometry, revision of chapter trigonometry. Let us quickly do the recap of what we have done yesterday. Relation among trigonometry ratios, table of trigonometry ratios of particular angles, trigonometry identity. So these three things we have done yesterday, and today we will be solving some of the sums based on this. Complete the given table. In this table, you can see tan theta as 1. So they have given us tan theta as 1, and we need to find sine theta and cos theta. And here you can see they have given us sine theta as 3 upon 5, and we need to find cos theta and tan theta. So let's start. So in the first one, they have given us tan theta equal to 1. So we will write first tan theta equal to 1. Then we all know that the formula of tan theta is tan theta equal to sine theta upon cos theta. We will number this as 1. Okay. Now in place of tan theta, we will write the value of it. And what is the value given to us? It is 1. Right? So in place of tan theta, I will write 1. And remaining we will copy as it is, that is equal to sine theta upon cos theta. And this we got from 1, and that is why we are writing here the reason as from 1. Now, the cos theta is over here is in divide form. So when you will transfer it to the left hand side of your equal to, it will get converted into multiply, and you will get sine theta equal to cos theta, because 1 into cos theta is cos theta, right? So this is the important point what we got. Sine theta is equal to cos theta, and we will number this as 2. Now yesterday we have done one identity, and we will make the use of that identity in this sum. Sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Now if you will see this identity and this second number, you can notice that sine theta is equal to cos theta, right? So what we will do in the next step, in the place of cos square theta, we will write sine square theta, because sine theta and cos theta are equal. So what we will get, sine square theta plus sine square theta equal to 1. And this we got from 2, right? So we will write here reason as from 2. Now, sine square theta plus sine square theta is nothing but 2 times sine square theta equal to 1. We will copy as it is. Now 2, here it is in multiply form. When we will transfer it to the right hand side of equal to, it will get converted into divide. So we will get sine square theta equal to 1 upon 2. Now here we got the answer of sine square theta, but we want to find sine theta. So what we will do, we will take the square root on both the sides. So taking the square root on both the sides, we will get sine theta equal to square root of 1 is 1, and the square root of 2 is under root 2, right? So this way we got sine theta as 1 upon root 2. The same value we will write in the table also, 1 upon root 2. Now, earlier only here we have got that sine theta is equal to cos theta. So sine theta answer we got 1 upon root 2. Then what will be the answer for cos theta? It will be 1 upon root 2, because sin theta and cos theta are equal over here, right? So we got the answer of cos theta also 1 upon root 2. So we will write the same value here also, 1 upon root 2. Now let us solve this second part of this table, where the sin theta is given as 3 upon 5 and we need to find cos theta and tan theta. Here, the sin theta was given to us as 3 upon 5. So first we will write sin theta is equal to 3 upon 5. Then we will write the trigonometry identity, that is sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. In the next step, we will substitute the value of sin theta, that is 3 upon 5. So here we will first write 3 upon 5, and since here it is square, we will put whole bracket square. And remaining we will copy as it is, means plus like plus cos square theta equal to 1, 1. In the next step, we will write the square of these numbers. The square of 3 is 9. The square of 5 is 25. Remaining copy as it is. Plus cos square theta equal to 1. Now again we will change the place of 9 upon 25 from left hand side to the right hand side of your equal to. So here it is plus 9 upon 25. When you will transfer it, the sign will get convert and you will get 1. That is from here 1. Minus 9 upon 25. So in the next step, you will get cos square theta is equal to 1 minus 9 upon 25. Now, we need to minus these two. For that, you need to equalize the denominator. Here, we will put 1. And since here the denominator is 25, I will multiply it with 25. So whatever number you are multiplying in the denominator, the same number multiply in the numerator also. So what you will get? You will get 25 upon 25 minus 9 upon 25. So now if you will look at the denominators, they are same, equal. So you can write it as common 25 and numerator you can minus. That is 25 minus 9. So in the next step, you will get cos square theta is equal to 25 minus 9 upon 25. So in the next step, we will subtract these numbers. Remaining we will copy as it is. Cos square theta equal to 25 minus 9 is 16. So 16 upon 25. Now we will find the square root of this. So cos square theta will get changed into cos theta. And the square root of 16 is 4. The square root of 25 is 5. So we got cos theta as 4 upon 5. Right? So we will write this in the table. 4 upon 5 cos theta. Now we need to find tan theta. So for tan theta, we have the formula as tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta, right? So this tan theta we will copy as it is. Equal to also we will copy as it is. Now in place of sin theta, we will write the value of it. What is the sin theta value over here? It is 3 upon 5. So we will write 3 upon 5. Then we have upon. Upon means divide. So here you can say divide. Then is cos theta. Cos theta value just now we got as 4 upon 5. So we will write 4 upon 5. Then in the next step, we will copy 3 upon 5 as it is. And we will convert this divide into multiply sign. So when you will do this, you need to write the reciprocal of the second term. And what is the second term given here? It is 4 upon 5. So the reciprocal will become 5 upon 4, right? Now, this 5 and this 5 will get cancelled. 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5. So 3 into 1 is 3. 1 into 4 is 4. So we got 10 theta as 3 upon 4. So we will write in the table also 3 upon 4. 3 upon 4. Just go through the sum. At the end, you have to write answer also. Answer, cos theta equal to 4 upon 5, comma, 10 theta is equal to 3 upon 4. Let us move to the next type of sums. Find the values of. Here they have given us 5 times sine 30 degree plus 3 times tan 45 degree. You need to find the values of this. To find the values of this, we will take the help of this table. This table we have done yesterday. Right? Here. With the help of this table, we will solve this sum. Let us start. First put equal to sign. 5 times. Times means multiply, right? So here we will write 5. Then multiply. Sine 30 degree. Now in the table, see what is the value of sine 30. Here you can see sine. And here you can see 30. So what is the value of sine 30 degree? It is 1 upon 2, right? So here we will write 1 upon 2 plus, because here plus sign is there, 3 times 10 45. So 3 as it is, times means multiply, 10 45 degree. Now again see what is the value of 10 45 degree in this table. Here you can see 10 and here you can see 45. So the value of 10 is 1. 10 45 degree is 1. So here we will write 1. Understood? Now here you can see multiply, here you can see plus, again multiply. Then what we will do first, multiply or plus? So for this, we will follow Bodmer's rule. What is Bodmer's rule? It is bracket, open, divide, multiply, add, subtract. So in this we have multiply and add. And if you will notice here, in this multiply comes first and add comes afterward. So because of that, we will do first multiply and then we will do add. Okay. So let us multiply these two first. And then we will multiply these two. Whatever answer we will get, we will add them up. Okay, so 5 ones are 5 upon 2 plus sign as it is, we will copy. 3 ones are 3. Now, to add these two, we need to equalize the denominator. So here I will put 1, and since here I am having 2, I will multiply this denominator with 2. Same number we will multiply in the numerator also. So you will get 5 upon 2 plus 3 twos are 6. And 1 multiplied by 2 is 2. Now the denominators are equal. So you can add the numerator. that is 5 plus 6, and denominator write common 1 times 2. 5 plus 6 is 11 upon 2. Okay. Now let us move to the next sum. 2 times sine 30 degree plus cos 0 degree plus 3 times sine 90 degree. Again, for solving this, we will take the help of this table. So you need to remember this table. So here, first we will write equal to. Now 2 times means 2 multiply sine 30 degree. What is the value of sine 30 degree in this table? It is 1 upon 2. You can see sine and here 30. So the value is 1 upon 2. So we will write here 1 upon 2. Then we have plus sine. So same we will copy as it is. Then we have cos 0 degree. What is the value of cos 0 degree? It is 1, right? So here we will write 1. Then we have plus. So plus we will copy as it is. 3 times means 3 multiply sine 90 degree. What is the value of sine 90 degree in this table? It is 1, right? So we will write here 1. Now we will do first multiply. 2 into 1 is 2 upon 2 plus 1, copy as it is, plus again copy as it is. 3 into 1 is 3. Now here if you will see, it is 2 upon 2. So we can cancel it. 2 ones are 2. So we got here 1. 1 upon 1 is nothing. 1 plus 1 plus 3. So what will be our answer? 1 plus 1 plus 3. The answer will be 5. Right? Now let us solve one more sum of the same type. Cos 60 degree into cos 30 degree plus sine 60 degree into sine 30 degree. Okay. So first we will put equal to sine again. Now here we have cos 60 degree. So in the table, see what is the value of cos 60 degree? It is 1 upon 2, right? So we will write here 1 upon 2. Then we have into sign, that is multiply. So we will copy as it is. The next one is cos 30 degree. What is the value of cos 30 degree? It is root 3 upon 2. So we will copy, we will write here root 3 upon 2. Then plus sign, copy as it is. Then we have sine 60 degree. What is the value of sine 60 degree? It is root 3 upon 2, right? So here we will write root 3 upon 2. Then we have into sine. So put into sine 30 degree. What is the value of sine 30 degree? It is 1, right? So here we will write 1. Now let us multiply. 1 into root 3 is root 3 upon 2 into 2 is 4. Then we have plus sign. Root 3 into 1 is root 3. And 2 into nothing means 1, right? Is 2. Now we need to equalize the denominator. We will multiply this with 2 so that it can become 4. It get converted into 4. Sorry, I did a mistake over here. Here it is sine 30 degree. So sine 30 degree value is 1 upon 2. By mistakely, I have taken this 1, but it is 90 degree. So in place of sine 30 degree, we will write 1 upon 2. Please notice this. By mistakely, I have written sine 90 value over here. It will come 1 upon 2. Sine 30 degree value is 1 upon 2. Now, let us multiply this also. Root 3 into root 3 is root, sorry, root 3 into 1 is root 3 and 2 into 2 is 4. Okay. Then if you will see, the denominators are same here, 4, 4. So directly we can write 4. We can take the common 4 and numerator we will add root 3 plus root 3. So root 3 plus root 3 is 2 times root 3 upon 4. Then we will reduce this. 2 ones are 2. 2 twos are 4. So we got the answer for this as root 3 upon 2. Okay. Now again see one more time. First we have cos 60 degree. The value of cos 60 degree is 1 upon 2. So I have written 1 upon 2, then into copy as it is. Then we have cos 30 degree. The value of cos 30 degree is root 3 upon 2. So we will write here root 3 upon 2, plus sine, copy as it is. Sine 60 degree, the value of sine 60 degree is root 3 upon 2. So we will copy this as root 3 upon 2, into write as it is. Then we have sine 30 degree. Sine 30 degree value is 1 upon 2. So we will write 1 upon 2. First we will do multiply. 1 into root 3 is root 3. 2 into 2 is 4. Plus sign, copy as it is. Root 3 into 1 is root 3. 2 into 2 is 4. Now the denominators are equal. So we will write it common. And numerator we will write root 3 plus root 3. root 3 plus root 3 is 2 times root 3 upon 4. Then we will reduce it in the table of 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. So we got the answer, final answer, as root 3 upon 2. Now, this is another type of sum. If sin theta is 4 upon 5, then find cos theta. Here they have given us the value of sin theta and we need to find the value of cos theta, right? So first, whatever is given, that we will write sin theta equals to 4 upon 5, and we will make the use of identity, that is sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Now, in the place of sin square theta, we will write the value of sin theta, which is given to us as 4 upon 5. Put whole bracket and write square. Plus. Remaining part we will copy as it is, because we are not having the value of cos theta we need to find. So we will copy this as it is, equal to 1. Now let us write the square of this number. 4 square is 16 and 5 square is 25, right? Remaining copy as it is. Now, in the next step, we will change the place of 16 upon 25 from the left-hand side to the right-hand side of equal to. So, plus 16 upon 25 will get converted into minus 16 upon 25. So, we will write cos square theta is equal to 1 minus 16 upon 25, right? So we will equalize the denominator. Since here it is 25, I'm multiplying it with 25 in the denominator as well as in the numerator also. This working you can do with pencil. So cos square theta is equal to 25 upon 25 minus 16 upon 25. Now, if you will look at the denominators, they are equal, so you can minus the numerator 25 minus 16. What answer you will get for 25 minus 16? It will be 9, right? So 9 upon 25. Now taking the square root on both the side, cos theta the square root of 9 is 3, right? We will write 3 over here. The square root of 25 is 5. So from this, we got the cos theta as 3 upon 5. Thank you. If cos theta is equal to 15 upon 17, then find sine theta. Here, they have given us the value of cos theta as 15 upon 17, and we need to find the value of sine theta. So whatever is given to us, we will write that first, that is cos theta equal to 15 upon 17. Then we will write trigonometry identity, that is sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. Now let us substitute the value which are given to us. So sine square theta we will write as it is. Plus, in place of cos theta, we will write the value which is given to us, 15 by 17 whole square equal to 1. Okay. So in the next step, we will copy remaining part as it is. So sine square theta plus, what is the square of 15? It is 225, right? So here we will write 225 upon. What is the square of 17? It is 289. So here you will get 289 equal to 1. In the next step, we will change the place of this from left hand side to the right hand side, and the sign will get converted into minus. So sine square theta is equal to 1 minus 225 upon 289. Okay. Now again we need to equalize the denominator. So after equalizing the denominator, what we will get? We will get sine square theta is equal to 289 upon 289, that is 289, minus 225 upon 289. So denominator we will write common, 289, and we will minus the numerator, 289 minus 225. So 289 minus 225 is 64, right? So here we will write 64 upon 289. So we got the answer of sine square theta as 64 upon 289. We need to find sine theta. So we will take the square root on both the side and we will get sine theta is equal to 8. The square root of 64 is 8 upon the square root of 289 is 17, right? So we got sine theta as 8 upon 17. Just go through the sum. Here it is given that in triangle PQR, angle Q equals to 90 degree. Angle P equal to theta, PQ is equal to 12, QR equal to 5, find cos theta. Now we need to find the cos theta, and the name of the triangle given to us is triangle PQR. So let's see the figure of this. Here we have PQR, triangle PQR, where angle Q is 90 degree. Then which side will be the hypotenuse? Side opposite to 90 degree. So here the side opposite to 90 degree is side PR. So here we will first write hypotenuse, right? Then here they have given angle P as theta. So we can see here angle P, mark this also as theta. PQ equal to 12. The length of side PQ is 12. So I am writing here 12. QR equal to 5. The length of side QR is given to us as 5. So here we can see QR. So here I am writing 5. Okay. Now if you will see this figure carefully, you can notice that we have the length of two sides, that is PQ and QR. And the length of hypotenuse, that is PR, is missing. So first we will find the length of the hypotenuse, and to find that we will take the help of Pythagoras theorem. The statement for Pythagoras theorem is hypotenuse square is equal to one side square plus other side square, right? So here the hypotenuse is PR. So we will write PR square is equal to, for one side we will write PQ square, and for QR, and for the other side we can write QR square, right? Now we will find the length of hypotenuse, that is PR square. So the value of PQ given to us is 12. So I'm writing here as 12. And put a bracket and write square over here. Plus we have QR square, and the length of QR is given to us is 5. So here we will write 5 and put a square. In the next step, we will square these numbers. We will write the square of 12. So the square of 12 is 144, right? Plus sign copy as it is. The square of 5 is 25. So 144 plus 25. If you will add these two numbers, you will get 169. So we got PR square equal to 169. Now we will take the square root of both the sides. So we will get PR equal to, the square root of 169 is 13, right? So I got PR as 13. So here in this figure, we will write 13 first. Now, they told us to find cos theta. So we will first write the formula for cos theta, that is adjacent side of angle theta upon hypotenuse, right? This is a formula which we have done earlier. So here, adjacent side of angle theta. Where is angle theta? Here, right? Angle P. Now, which side is adjacent to angle P? Side PQ. Side PQ. So here we will write PQ. Upon hypotenuse. What is the name of the side? Hypotenuse. PR. PR. Right? So here we will write PR. Let me write P again. Okay. Then we will write the value or the length of the sides. PQ, it is 12, right? The length of PQ given to us is 12. So here we will write 12 upon PR. What is the length of PR? The length of PR is 13, right? So here we will write 13. So we got cos theta as 12 upon 13. Just go through the sum. It is very easy. Pythagoras theorem we have done earlier also. First we will apply Pythagoras theorem to this triangle and we will get the length of hypotenuse as 13, right? And then we will write the formula of cos theta, that is adjacent side of angle theta upon hypotenuse. And then we will write the sides name and we will substitute the values which are given to us and we will arrive at the answer, that is 12 upon 13. So thank you everyone. Have a good day. Take care. Bye.